Hey all, welcome to Cheap Jeep here on TFL Truck. That of course is our 1989 Jeep Comanche, and it's probably the perfect truck ever.
Welcome to Moab, Utah. All right, Tommy, we like to call this one butt clencher.
Holy scrapes, that right there was not brilliant.
It's hard to tell you exactly how steep this is, but it's super steep.
Now, last week we said that we'd be comparing our Comanche to something old, like a Samurai. Old versus old. It was gonna be great. It was gonna be off-road. But it's May 21st right now, and it just had a blizzard. So all the off-road trails are closed. So we're gonna do something fun instead. Now, I know it's old and it's pretty creaky and it smells funny and it squeaks too much, but it actually is an absolutely brilliant truck. And today in this video, we're gonna go over all the reasons that the Jeep Comanche is pretty much the best pickup truck ever. You see, if you bought a truck in the 80s, well, you pretty much were buying an appliance, a tool. I mean, it sucked pretty much at everything but doing truck stuff. And that's where the Jeep Comanche came in, because this was a really special blend of work hard, play hard. Yeah, you could put hay and plywood in the bed, but up front it was pretty comfortable and it didn't suck. The interior is not particularly luxurious, but it's super comfortable, and I think that's something we've lost in a lot of modern day trucks. Yes, we've got a lot of features and a lot of exciting gadgets, but some of the comfort seems to have disappeared in the pursuit of lumbar support. Now, the Comanche has none of that, but it does have a bench seat, and it's cushy and it's wide and it will fit a big American butt, and I really love that. It also sits three across, which is helpful. Plus, it does another cool thing. You pull a little latch and the whole thing scoots forward, and you have a surprising amount of space back here. Like I said, the bench seat is great because you got a lot of room laterally. You also have just a surprising amount of room in this cabin in general. No, you're not going to be able to take your kids to the soccer practice, but that's not what the Comanche is about. It's about being capable, comfortable, and good off-road, and for that, the interior is perfect. Now, check this out. Tons and tons of headroom. The seat can go back even further. I've got tons and tons of legroom. I'm about 6'1", and even still, I have no problem getting comfortable with legroom, which is something that's a little bit rare in some of these older single cab pickup trucks. But the steering wheel is my favorite part of the entire interior. It's, well, you probably think it's a little bit boring. It's three spokes and it's got a rim. But when you really look at it, it is the perfect steering wheel. It's not too thick, but it's not too thin. It's got these amazing, and I mean amazing, I mean even by modern standards they look brilliant. These spokes that come out from the center, they're aluminum, they're brushed, they're beautiful. It's the right size, it's got the right center cap in it. They use these steering wheels in all sorts of Jeeps, from Comanches to Wranglers. I'm nerding out on this, but it's my favorite steering wheel of all time, because it's just, it does everything that it needs to do, and it looks like it should be out of a 1930s race car, not in a Jeep. Okay, so from here forward, well, this Jeep is basically exactly identical to the Cherokee. A little sister to the Comanche, if you will. Now, the Cherokee was unibody, and it was a great little Jeep. It was comfortable, it was somewhat fuel efficient, it was pretty good off-road, but it was really great at just being an everyday driver. Now, Jeep took the best parts of the Cherokee, the comfort and the refinement, and added on a lot of usability out back. Okay, so on the road in the 89 Comanche, and it's fine. It's a pickup truck. I mean, you push the accelerator and it accelerates. You push the brakes and it stops. You steer the wheel and it steers. I mean, it's not a Miata, guys. It's not a 911, but it's fine. It does everything a pickup truck needs to do. The engine is silky smooth. This one is going on, what, 31 years old now. And let's see what works and what doesn't. Horn, yep, the horn works. Lights, that all works. Windshield wipers, that's fine. The radio's aftermarket, that doesn't work. Temperature, up, fan, yep, that, it just works. It's just a great place to spend time on a road trip. It's a great place to drive along in. Now, there's a fundamental issue with the Cherokee that this truck is based on, because the Cherokee is a unibody, and that's great for a refined ride, but it's not so great for, we'll call it truck stuff. So what Jeep did very cleverly is develop something called a uniframe for the Comanche. See, the forward part that's based on the Cherokee is still a unibody, but the back, the business, the bed, it's on a frame. And there's actually a huge X member underneath the bed. Now, all this meant is that the Comanche had a huge, and I mean an astronomically large payload capacity. equivalent to about the same of a full-size truck of the era. You'll notice that on all modern Jeeps, they all have 7 slots in their grill, and they say that's a big heritage thing, but that's not entirely true, because the very first Jeeps had 9 slots, then they went to 21, they had 8, they had 10. This Jeep actually has an 8-slotted grill. It wasn't until the late 1990s that Jeep went to 7 slots entirely. So yes, it's true that 7 slots is the typical Jeep number, and yes, it's true that a lot of the most iconic Jeeps have had 7 slots, but count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The Comanche, at least this year, has 8 of them. The other thing that Jeep got super right on this interior are the gauges. Now this one has an optional gauge package, so it's got all the stuff you need, but nothing you don't. And they're very 80s, they're very retro, and they're super fun to look at because they're red and they're black and they're white and they're sporty and they're super aggressive and Terminator. But what you'll notice is on the left you've got your temperature gauge, your fuel gauge, and you've got your tach and your speedometer, and you've got oil pressure and volts. Like, that is everything you really need in a truck. You don't have to search through menus to find them. They're always there. They're always looking cool. They're always ready to give you a smile. It's getting kind of rare nowadays to find a single cab truck at all. And this Comanche is only available in single cab with 2 bed configurations. There was a 6-foot bed and a 7-foot bed. This one is a short bed, but it still is big by modern standards. Now, the other cool thing is this truck is lifted something like 3.5 inches. It's got a really big tire on it. And look, what a concept. I can even still, with this big lift and 4-wheel drive, touch the bed. I can get inside of it pretty easily. I can hop on up. There's tie downs in the front. This truck really was built for work, and it's got a lot of capability back here that you really kind of are losing in some of the modern day midsize trucks. Probably the coolest part of the Comanche's exterior design are these wheels. These are called the turbine style wheels. They're 10 slots. They are absolutely epic in design, 15 inches. Now, of course, this Comanche is lifted with some bigger tires, and it really fills out the wheel well. Overall, though, I really wish that Jeep would come back with this wheel design. It's simple, but it's really elegant. No power sliding rear window in the Comanche, but if you can't reach over and slide it open like that, you probably shouldn't be driving a truck in the first place. But it works really well. Put the windows down, have this window open, you get a nice airflow throughout the cab. 4-litre. Yeah, there was a certain era of these Jeeps where they thought they could bring in a little bit of class, a little bit of sophistication by spelling liter, L-I-T-R-E, like they do in Europe. Now, I'm gonna be honest, I'm not really sure why they do it, but the 4-litre is by far the best part of this truck. I do have a theory, actually, why maybe it's spelled a little bit more, we'll call it European, than we would here in the US. You see, back in the mid-80s, Jeep was still owned by the American Motors Corporation, and they had a partnership with the French and Peugeot and Renault, and maybe that's where that comes from. But here's the engine. As the French would say, it's the 4-litre, and it's brilliant. It's a really, really great engine. Silky smooth, straight 6, 177 horsepower, 220 pound-feet of torque. When Jeep debuted this engine in the late 80s in the Comanche, I don't want to say it destroyed the competition on power numbers, but it annihilated every other truck in its class. The Toyota was down like 25 horsepower, the Nissan and some of the others were down even more than that, up to 40 horsepower. Jeep really did an amazing thing with the 4-litre straight 6. It was bulletproof, it was really reliable, but there's some French bits on here that aren't so good. This mess of wires isn't so great. You see, the French are really good at building croissants, but they're not so good at building engine management systems. And this is a system known as Renix, which is a combination of Renault and Bendix. And it's kind of a disaster. It's got a lot of issues with grounding. It's got a lot of issues with connectors. It's well before OBD2, so you have to have a special computer to read it. It is a problem, if you will, and one that's not brilliant. Now, of course, later on, they got rid of the Renix system in the Comanche and the Cherokee, and they went to a different system, which was way better, and then the 4-litre was pretty much perfect. But if I could just get rid of all this and put in something better, then you'd be really set. One issue that Jeep had on the early Comanches is that the hoods fluttered like crazy and they bounced around, especially off-road. So what they did to fix the issue is they simply put 2 hood latches on the Cherokee and Comanche, and it works pretty well, but it seems like a over-engineered solution to a problem that doesn't need to exist. So So at this point, you're probably thinking, well, why the heck are you saying it's a perfect truck? Because it seems like it got a lot of stuff wrong. Yeah, but it also got a lot of stuff really right, because Jeep does a lot of things poorly, but the one thing that they always do well is off-road capability, and the Comanche is no exception. It actually has solid axles in the front and the back, and there's no mid-size truck available today with solid axles. I mean, it's very rare to find any truck available today with solid axles, let alone a four-wheel drive off-road capable one. Next great thing about the Comanche is there is a ton of storage. And I don't mean center console, because there's not one of those, but other than that, there's a lot of it. You've got these big pockets down here in the door. You also have some little cubbies here on the shifter, but my favorite is this cubby here in the dashboard. Now, I don't know if they intended this. My bet is they probably didn't in the mid-1980s, but it's perfect for holding your phone when you're putting along. It's great for holding odds and ends, and it also has a really big glove box. Now, it's not down here where you'd expect it. It's actually up here. And it hinges the wrong way. We've got a tilt steering wheel here. You pull this little lever and it's actually spring-loaded up, but that's not the weird part. The weird part is how far it tilts down. I mean, that is, I think, below 90 degrees. This is pretty old school too, and it's something that you use all the time being a manual transmission. That, of course, is your parking brake. It's a foot brake, which means you're probably not gonna be doing cool handbrake turns, but at least it'll stop it from rolling down a hill. Of course, being in the 1980s, fuel economy was kind of a big deal, and Jeep gave you a shift light that comes on that lets you know when you need to upshift. I mean, it doesn't matter if you're at 800 RPM or 2000 RPM or 4000 RPM, basically the truck wants you to upshift and save fuel all of the time. Being based on the Cherokee, in the front, the Comanche uses Jeep's brilliant quadrilink suspension. It's got coil springs, it's super comfy. But Jeep realized that that probably wouldn't fly in the back being a pickup truck. So we got good old-fashioned leaf springs in the rear, and they're actually also pretty comfy. Now this one, of course, has our TerraFlex lift kit on it and our BFG 33-inch tires, so it's probably not as comfy as it was when it was brand new, just because we've got such a big tire under there. But even still, you kind of just cruise down the road at a comfortable speed and everything is fine in the world because you got yourself the perfect pickup truck. The thing is, there's not one part of the Comanche that's all that brilliant. That's better than any other truck. I mean, yeah, it's got a pretty good sized bed, but there's trucks with bigger beds, and yeah, it's pretty comfortable, but there's trucks that are certainly more comfortable, and yeah, it's pretty good off-road, but there are certainly trucks that are much better off-road. But it just does everything pretty well, and when you combine all those pretty wells into one package, it kind of becomes a really well situation. The engine is super smooth. If I could buy a mid-sized truck with an engine that had that much low-end torque and was that reliable, I would, because the Tacoma engine is great, but it does nothing below like 3,500 RPM. And if I could buy a truck that was that off-road worthy, but also that size, that would be great, because the ZR2 Colorado is great off-road, but it's also a little big and the visibility is poor. And if I could buy a truck that would haul as well as that truck does, that would be great, because yes, the Ford Ranger is way faster and has a higher payload capacity and tows a lot more, but the bed is just a lot less usable. It's less long and I can't reach into it. The thing is the Comanche is the perfect size. It's the perfect design. It's pretty good off-road. It's really comfortable. It's just a great all-around package. And I know you guys in the comments are gonna be like, it's an old truck. Technology has gone by. Everything nowadays is way better. And yes, that's true, because the transmission is absolutely horrendous. The engine management system sucks. They rusted out. They weren't safe, but they were perfect.
Coming up next time on the Jeep Pickup Challenge.
As always, I'm Tommy with the Fastlane Truck. Go back to tfltruck.com for more news, views, and real-world reviews. And next week, we really are going to try to do our old versus old with the Comanche and the Samurai Off-Road.